two parachutes will come out to retard the aircraft. Great to see back in the RIAT flying program, then for the second successive year from the 831st Guard Tactical Aviation Brigade of the Ukrainian Air Force was deployed 227P1M. Well, just one item now remains, and fittingly, in this RAF 100 year, it's the front line of the Royal Air Force. And His Royal Highness Prince Michael of Kent, and it features a parade of the new Queen's colour for the Royal Air Force in the United Kingdom. That parade will parade square itself, and you can view the ceremony on big screens in the Green Service Station and the Vintage Village. Then, the Royal Review commences at 11 o'clock and runs through until 12 noon. That will see His Royal Highness the Duke of Kent and the Chief of the Air Staff making a tour of the static line of RAF aircraft in open top of vehicle, starting off from the eastern end of the showground. And they'll also be touring some of the international static participants as well. Once the Royal Review element has been completed, the next stage of today's special festivities is the flight path I was describing at 2:15 this afternoon. Solo Turk. And there we see Captain Gunnar streaming. Captain Doyan, who will be flying the display tomorrow, will be at the Solo Turk stand to meet you, to post the photographs with you and answer your questions. They thank you for your support and your attendance. And I think also, Ben, worthy of mention, Captain Emre Vira, who has entertained the crowds of RIAT during the Solo Turk commentary for the last 4 or 5 years, has actually...